Hi everyone, this is John Flask and I'm here with Kathy Chu, and we just got our copies of Spectrum 23 and I wanted to open up the book and share the experience with you. On the cover we have a piece of work by Android Jones, which is titled The Year of the Ram. I think it's an exquisite piece of art and it's something that I'm honored to get to do each year, which is pick the piece of work that goes on the cover of the book. And I do this by going through every submission that comes in very carefully and then looking for something I think is really going to draw the reader in and represent Spectrum well and just serve as a beautiful piece of artwork. And this was the one that jumped out to me and I wanted to use, and I just love it. And thank Android for allowing us to use it on the cover. As we open the book and view the initial interior pages, these are also areas where I get to pick works which I feel highlighted the year and represent Spectrum's motto of showcasing the best in contemporary fantastic art. I like Julie Bell's Behind the Veil so much, I used it here on the half title page and also on the back cover of the book. And on the next page, on the title page, we have Bayard Yu's piece, which is this amazing, awesome, high energy, high fantasy piece, which I just loved and thought it served perfectly for that page. And then for the contents page, I got to highlight a work by Vance Kovacs, and I thought it served as an excellent example for this page. And I always start off the books by showcasing the jury for the year. And I gotta say, this group got along amazingly well. They took their roles very seriously. They carefully reviewed each of the submitted works. And they also had a great time during the day. There was a lot of laughing and they really did great together. And for this year, we had David Palumbo, also Cynthia Shepherd and Kirk Thatcher, Charlie Wen and Tara Whitlatch, who are all superb artists, educators. They serve as dynamos in the industry. I've included sample art for them, pictures and bios, so you can get to know who they are if you don't already. And if you're curious how I select and assemble the jury each year, what I aim to do is seek out those who get along well with others, they have a positive social media presence, they do outstanding work, they have a shared love for digital and traditional methods, are well-versed and informed on a wide range of contemporary fantastic art, and who give back to the community through sharing online, teaching, or in other ways. And I feel these need to be all-around exceptional people in the industry, and without a doubt, these five all fall within those guidelines that I've set forth. And as we move on, there's a spread in the Spectrum 23 Awards Ceremony that was held at the Society of Illustrators in New York City. And then on the next page, we have Claire Wendling, who did the Call for Entries poster, also highlighted Victor Mowry, who is the recipient of the Rising Star Award that was selected by the award creators, Colin and Christine Poole. Then, a four-page feature on the Spectrum Grandmaster, Mike Mignola. The award is a custom-made bronze made by Colin and Christine Poole, dubbed as Hellgirl. The requirements for someone to be considered for a Spectrum Grandmaster Award includes them having to have had a career spanning at least 20 years, having achieved a level of excellence in their work that they've maintained throughout the course of their career, have inspired other artists with their attitudes and accomplishment, and must still be living. The recipient is decided upon by the Spectrum Advisory Board that includes Braun, Alex Carter, Mark Sciarello, Kathy and Arnie Fenner, Rebecca Gay, Jim Gurney, Charles Kochman, Ian McCaig, Virginie Ropars, Tim Underwood, and Harlan Ellison, with me moderating the process. And then next up, we have the year in review, where I focus on trends, changes, and issues that face the year, along with noting exceptional news that relate to the eight categories found within Spectrum that include advertising, books, comics, concept art, dimensional, editorial, institutional, and unpublished. And then we get to the beating heart of what makes Spectrum so special right here with the works that were selected for inclusion into Spectrum 23, the magnificent, exceptional, outstanding works of art that made up the year. I can look over this book countless times and I never grow tired of it. And each section starts off with the gold and silver award recipients for each category, which is highlighted by the work that won, with a photo, additional art, and bio so you can learn more about the artist. And highlighting these artists is important to me. I want people to see that these are real people that can be found all over the world and are as diverse as the subject matters found within the book. Spectrum really is a massively eclectic mix that spans generations, approaches, tools, styles, that favors being different and those who take risks. By welcoming all and not pre-screening the art, you get the best range that art has to offer for the year. And I'd really like to thank everyone who submitted to Spectrum, to those who pick up the book each year. You have our most humble gratitude for your support, and we're going to keep doing our best to make this the absolute greatest art annual on the planet. And hope you enjoy it.
Spectrum has always been something that I looked at as inspiration and as something that was really kind of an aspiration when I was starting out, and a place that I could kind of see really kind of what the bar was that I needed to be aiming for. I think just a really valuable way for me to kind of stop and take a look at, around me and see if I'm still moving in a direction that I want to be going in.
Spectrum continues to be one of the best tools I have now as an art director, and we have as a collective group of people, as a community, to just sort of showcase what's been going on every year, check out trends, check out new faces, check out what people who've been in the industry for a long time have been doing, and just really catch up. It's the yearbook for our industry, right?
It inspires me every year. It gives me ideas. It shows me various styles that are coming up. You know, you'll see a particular artist and he's very popular, and suddenly there's three or four clones, and then they kind of grow into their own thing. And you also learn that good art, it doesn't matter what the medium is, it's still good design, good color sense, no matter what the tools are.
I think Spectrum is a touchstone to go back to year after year to see what's going on, what people are doing, what are some of the trends in art, to get inspired, all of that richness. And it is a wonderful, wonderful tool as an artist. And it's just sheer enjoyable just to look at. So yes, I love Spectrum.